If you have a project that requires end-user input for settings and such, and don't have a touch screen, you've probably needed some type of a menu system. But if you've ever tried to write menu in code, it tends to be a pain. And if you have a display with an ILI9341 driver, this library is just the ticket. My library has two types of menus. The first menu type is a simple selection list. Watch how we dance up and down each of the items in the list. If there happen to be any disabled entries, we'll skip over it automatically. Upon selection, a submenu can be launched, and that takes us to the second type of a menu. The second type allows editing within each of the menu items. As you dance up and down the items, notice how there's a column for the actual value. Upon selection, you can freely edit the value in the column. The column can be two types of data: pure numerical data, where we'll scroll through each of the values that you've provided from a high value to a low value, or editing from a list. And a selection list is perfect for where you want users to pick something from a defined list, like a baud rate, for example, or a way to control the unit of measure readout in your display, from like inches to millimeters, for example. This library is pretty robust. Each menu item can have an icon, there's a title bar, and you can control all of the characteristics such as colors, margins, fonts, and even a border around the menu selector bar. If you're using displays other than an IL9341, you will have to do some editing and change the object types in the argument definitions. Let's have a look at the code. I'll try to keep the code review short and sweet. The example that I provided will show how to create both menu types, a selection menu or an editable menu. As with any program, you'll want to include all the libraries. There's my ILI9341 menu, along with the display drivers and some fonts. I'm using encoder here, but you could use standard push buttons if you wanted to. My colors are all in defines, and I'm using the ILI9341 definitions and some of my own. Typical pin definitions for your encoders, chip select, and a few other things. One of my personal favorites is using a define for your fonts. That way, if you change your font in the define, it ripples through all of your code and updates all of the fonts. You will have to have a simple int for each of your menu items, and this is the return value so we know which ID is associated with which line item. Now, the editable data itself is actually a float, so you can go through a wide range of values from negative to positive and include decimal points. I have some char arrays for things like menu text and item text. You don't have to use char arrays for the actual menu items itself, but if you do, there is a subtle difference between how menu items and lists within a menu item are treated. Editable lists within an item can be zero-based, meaning your array starts at zero. However, the actual menu items themselves have to be starting at the one position. Zero is reserved for exit. If you want your users to make a selection from a list, that has to be a char array, and here are a few examples: baud rate, yes-no values, things of that nature. Just create a char array of whatever size that you need, and the library will automatically present that char array when the user decides to make a selection to a particular row item that allows at an editable list. Later, we'll see how the add method allows you to define whether you have the user choose from a list or cycle through a range of values. If you want icons, there's a cool little website there that will take a color icon or a monochrome icon and turn it into a good old-fashioned Arduino C code. However, they're big. Of the 15 icons or so, it's 1,500 lines of code. Fire your display up as you typically would do, and if you want to create a menu item for just selections, that is called the item menu object type, and I'm giving it a name of main menu. The edit menu allows selection and editing of each of the values within the row item. So just keep in mind that there are two different menu types. I'm going to create two different editable menus, one for some sensors and one for some wireless inputs. These are all fictitious, but you get the idea. Fire up your encoder or your mechanical buttons, whatever you happen to be using. I have a LED pin that I use to turn my display on and off. Here's how you initialize your main menu. You're going to have to pass in a fair number of parameters like text color, background colors, title text, item font, and a few other things. Hopefully the documentation here is good enough for you to be able to pick this up on your own. Now that your main menu is initialized, time to add some actual rows. And that's what the add object does, or the add method does. You can add no icon, add a mono icon, or add it with a 565 color icon. You just pass in a few labels and the icon itself and the size of the icon. Pretty simple inputs here. By default, the library allows a maximum of 15 line items. If you need more, simply open the .h file and find it a define called max underbar opt. Change the 15 to whatever value that you need. There's also a max char len define that allows the maximum character lengths. If you have very long text, you might increase that. You can decrease these numbers to save a little bit of memory. Remember, the item menu object does not have a way to edit line items, so there are no parameters for lists or values. We'll see that in the next type. If you want to disable something, there is a disable or an enable. I'm just disabling something to give you an example of what that item will look like. Then, these are all optional, but if you want to set the text title colors, the text title bar size, margins, things of that nature, you can do that in a subsequent method call. If you want to disable some items, you have to set the disable color. Again, there is a default in the library, but it may not work with a black background or a white background, and things like border colors. Now, if you want to add an editable menu, the process is exactly the same. There's an init, but a few more arguments in there. Things like select bar color and select bar background color. And then, as you would expect, there is an add method for each of your menu items. For these editable selection menus, here's where you define whether you want your selection to be from a list or cycle through a range of values. Regardless, you have to have a low value and a high value and an increment. For a range of values, simply specify a float for your low, your high range, your increment, and the number of decimal places. If you're using an item list, your low value will be 0 because that's the first element of your array, and the high value will be the number of elements in your array. And here's the math to figure all that out. You'll want to increment your list by 1, but you don't need any decimal places. There is an argument for defining to use a list or not. Just like before, you can set colors, set margins, set a few other things to get the exact control over the location of where text is to be drawn on your screen. I'm going to add one more editable menu here, and I won't spend a whole lot of time explaining it. You can kind of take a look at the code, the example, and see that things like channel, that's going to be scrolling through a list. But something like error data rate, I want it to scroll through an actual char array. You can add some values for your initial, so there is a way to pre-populate your values in the user interface. So if your channel is always, you want to remember that and present that to the user, store that in a variable and just present that. A good way of doing this is store this in the EEPROM. When you fire up your Teensy, you'll read the value out of the EEPROM, update the variable there, and it would be presented in the UI. And then, of course, save that when you're done with the menu edit item. Now, getting the actual menu to work, I highly recommend putting it in its own function, like a process main menu. That way you can call this anywhere from your program. It will draw the menu, let the user dance through all the items, and then return control back to your program when you're actually done. What that looks like here is simply a process main menu. There's a few variables to track what items are, and there's the infamous draw main menu draw item. Then I'm going to simply loop through this thing until the user exits the menu by hitting the exit to option, which is the main title bar. I'm doing the best job I can of debouncing these encoders, which is not easy to do. If you're moving your encoder up, there's a move up method, and if you're moving it down, there's a move down method. My encoder also has a set button, so if I press a button on a menu item, we'll select the row, and then we'll process accordingly. We process the sensor menu, we process some other driver menu, which I don't have here, or process a wireless menu. That is processing for an item menu object type, and fortunately, the edit menu processing is exactly the same. Again, we're going to draw the sensor menu, and we're going to put it into a loop that's going to continue to iterate until the user exits out of that. If your encoder goes up, we move up. If your encoder goes down, or your button is in a down, down button, you move down. If you select an item row, the object is smart enough to know that you want to edit that. It will put you into an editing mode. As you move your encoder up or down, we will automatically cycle through either the list or the range of values that you've input. So the move down and move up moves to the menus, but it also moves to the individual items within that menu. So it's a dual purpose type of a method call. Selecting a selected row will exit the editing and put you back in general menu selection. The library is smart enough to manage all these interactions. This is an example here that if you change one value, like you turn off an alarm, for example, or turn it on, maybe you want to disable something else and change some item text. Here's how you would do that. You simply get the value. There's a value property on each of the menu items, and you simply make a decision. What do you want to do with it? And then you can change other menu items based on that. When the user is done editing, they simply scroll up to the title bar. It turns into an exit. They select that, and you're out of the menu. Here you can process each of the individual menu item entries. You can save these to an EEPROM, change your Teensy parameters or your device parameters or whatever you want to do with this particular data. Last example here, or last function here, is the process wireless menu. Same exact process here. I'm not going to explain exactly what's going on. Just remember that if your encoder or your button is up, there's a move up. It dances through the menus. Move down is the same type of thing. If you select a menu item, we will put you in editing, and the move up and the move down will simply cycle through each of the items in that menu. Well, hopefully this will help you write cool projects and get menuing code up and running much, much quicker. Thanks for watching.